Want to deal with canal folds. Canal fold means it's an irrigation structure which is constructed across a canal. So canal fold is an irrigation structure which is constructed across a canal, and it serves for two purposes. The first one is to lower its water level, to lower the level of water. Canal fold means it's an irrigation structure which is constructed across a canal, and it serves two purposes. First one is to lower the water level. And the second one is the main function, to destroy the surplus energy. That means to destroy the excess energy which is liberated by the water, which is liberated by the fallen water, which may otherwise cover the beds and banks of the canal. That means first one is to lower the water level, and the second one is to destroy the excess energy of the falling water. To destroy the excess energy of the falling water, otherwise what will happen is that that particular falling water will scour the beds and banks of the canal. Scour means it's a flushing effect of water, or the flushing action of water is termed as scouring. So canal fold is an irrigation structure which is constructed across the canal. It serves for two main functions. The first one is lower the water level, and the second one is to destroy the excess energy which is liberated by the falling water, which may otherwise, if it is not destroyed, if the surplus energy is not destroyed, that falling water will scour the beds as well as the banks of the canal. So that's a canal fold, and these are the two main functions of the canal fold. Now we can see what are the different types of canal folds. Types of fold: the first one, vertical drop fold; second one, ogee fold; third one, rapid fold; fourth one, stepped fold; and the fifth one is notch fold. We can see first one is vertical drop fold. In case of a vertical drop fold, it consists of a vertical drop wall. That is, the vertical drop fold consists of a vertical drop wall and a cistern. You can see the upstream region and the downstream region. We know the water is flowing from the upstream region to the downstream region, and the water flows over the crust segment. And after flowing over the crust segment, the water flows into a cistern. And in that cistern, the cistern is a portion where the surplus energy of the water, where the surplus or the excess energy of the water which is leaving the crust, that is, you can see that the movement of the water is from upstream to downstream. So the water moves from the upstream, then towards the crust, then the water comes to the cistern, and afterwards to the downstream region. So the excess energy of the water which is flowing over the crust is destroyed when it comes in the water cushion. That is, this particular region is a cistern, and it provides a water cushion. The function of cistern, that is, the function of the cistern is to destroy the surplus energy or destroy the excess energy of the water which is leaving the crust segment. That is, destroying the excess energy of the water which is flowing after the crust segment. That is a function of the cistern. And you have learned about the design and drawing of Sarda type fold. The Sarda type fold is a kind of vertical drop fold. Okay, so Sarda type fold is a kind of vertical drop fold. So I hope you have clear about vertical drop fold. You can see an upstream segment, downstream segment, and this is a crust. The water flows over the crust towards the cistern, and in the cistern, the excess energy of the water which is flowing over the crust is destroyed. Now the second one is ogee fold. Ogee fold means it consists of gradual convex as well as concave curves. That is, you can see in the picture, it consists of several gradual convex as well as convex curves, so as to provide a smooth transition. That is, ogee fold in the picture, you can see it consists of several convex as well as concave curves, so as to provide a smooth transition and to reduce the disturbance and impact. It consists of smooth convex as well as concave curves, so as to provide a smooth transition of water so that we can reduce the disturbance and impact. That is about an ogee fold. And this photograph shows an ogee fold. It consists of gradual convex and concave curves to provide a smooth transition of water. Now next one is rapid fall. Rapid fall consists of a glacis which is sloping, which is having a slope between 1 in 10 to 1 in 20. That is, you can see that it has a slope ranging between 1 in 10 to 1 in 20, and in the picture you can see that the rapid fall is having a slope of 1 in 15. The picture is clear, it is having a slope of 1 in 15, and the slope can range between 1 in 10 to 1 in 20 for a rapid fall. It consists of a glacis which is sloping, and the slope ranges from 1 in 10 to 1 in 20, that is between 1 in 10 to 1 in 20. And in the picture you can see a slope of 1 in 15. Next is a photograph of a rapid fall. The slope can range between 1 in 10 to 1 in 20. Next, third one is stepped fall. Stepped fall means it's a development over rapid fall. That is, it's a modified form of rapid fall. You have seen rapid fall. This is a rapid fall. And the coming is a stepped fall. You can see that the stepped fall is a development over rapid fall, or we can say it's a modified form of rapid fall. But it's one of the defect is that its construction cost is higher. It's a modified form or rapid fall, and its construction cost is higher. The photograph shows a stepped fall. Next is a trapezoidal notch fall. A notch fall, we have learned about the trapezoidal notch fall. We have learned the design, the theory part, and the drawing, etc. in the previous class. The trapezoidal notch fall. Next is Sada type fall. That I have explained that Sada type fall is a kind of vertical drop fall. Sada type fall means it's a kind of vertical drop fall. And it was introduced. It was introduced to replace a notch fall on the Sarda canal system in Uttar Pradesh. It's a kind of vertical drop fall, and it was introduced to replace a notch fall on the Sarda canal system in Uttar Pradesh. And talking about the design of a Sarda type fall, the first step is the design of the crust. So we can see that the two types of crust are used. Two shapes of crust are used, and one is trapezoidal crust and the next one is rectangular crust. Okay, so when you have learned about the design, I told you that we are using two shapes of crust walls, and one shape is trapezoidal shape and the next shape is rectangular shape. You can see that why we are using trapezoidal and rectangular, that there are several criteria, and the first one is the discharge is less than 14 cubics. That is, if the discharge is up to 14 cubics, can use a rectangular crust, and if the discharge exceeds 14 cubics, we are using a trapezoidal crust. Okay, so the first step is a Sada canal system means it's a vertical drop fall, and it was introduced to replace the notch fall on the Sada canal system in Uttar Pradesh. And two types of crust walls are used. One is rectangular crust, and the next one is trapezoidal crust. We are using a rectangular crust when the value of discharge is below 14 cubics, and we are using a trapezoidal crust when the discharge value exceeds 14 cubics. As you can see that when Q is less than 14 cubics, or when Q is up to 14 cubics, we are using a rectangular crust, and when the value of Q exceeds 14 cubics, we are using a trapezoidal crust. That is about the design of crust. It's the first step in design of crust. We are using two shapes, trapezoidal and rectangular. I hope you have understood the situation where we use a trapezoidal and where we use a rectangular crust.